let's consider emotion like a meta information, so a way of conveying information. So in this case, just to justify my emotional state at the moment. Well, thank you for having me here. Okay. So, my futuristic experience at ABC was great, colorful, and passionate. And of course, I have just 5 minutes, so very short time in comparison to the others, but I'll try to apply my best heuristic, that is less is more in this case, hopefully. So, what ABC is meaning to me even now is not just a place, it's much more something that will be extending over the time. And let me just summarize what are the main messages that I'm taking with me in my new experience here. And also in the future here in IBM. I started growing my ideas with a lot of freedom, so I developed very interesting projects, and I tried to be bolder than in the past. So there to there was a very strong message from Gerd, and that we are trying to apply every time in this complex world. So also another thing that is happening helping me very much in this time, that whether I'm also a researcher but also a consultant at IBM and IBM Research, is to envision a usable science. So IBM is doing a lot of progress and developing nice technologies also because somehow these values also are embedded also in IBM where I'm working, so it's a sort of continuity that I'm really appreciating. And going across domains, so I'm also starting new challenging and having your grand challenge view in mind. What were my simple and humble seed at IBC? Together with Gerd and our team, we were developing two quite nice projects. They were the first attempt to mix finance and medicine together to assess whether people are facing complexity, uncertainty, jargonity, and technical meanings in the two different domains. We were assessing how heuristic would work in the two different domains. And we started the two projects, the county banking and word that care, to emphasize the fact that also wording and storytelling were very important to convey the right messages to patients. And at this time, I want to remark the time. It was 2008 around, and IBM was moving, it's just moving now, just now, into cognitive solution in terms of application for cognition, just now. So we were anticipating more than 10 years that this stuff. And also the investments in healthcare from my corporation has been starting 5 years ago in the healthcare domains, just to support the doctor and patient relationships. So we were really straightforward in that regard. And this was my team, Marcus Feuchel is here, other people around the world, I was very happy to collaborate with. And there was a promise before leaving IBC, and that I try to maintain, hopefully, and was to implant some of the ABC spirit also in IBM while moving there. And spirit is something that is very difficult to be representing features, but I try to represent meta features, so how we are considering features. And the first result was to consider UTEC, so heuristic based technology. My promise was to start project developing technology that are continuously suitable for humans, and they were, say, heuristic based in terms of reading. And this was somehow some of our aims at that time, and I hope that I keep my promise in developing technologies for oncology. I've been working for more than 3 years in the oncology domain by helping doctors and patients to represent information about long-term treatments that are very painful from time to time, to envision future results and to overcome risk comprehension difficulties. So this was part of my stuff. But more recently, I'm moving even forward in the sense that we are trying to help machines and humans to come up with common sense on complex concepts, and designing ontologies, and designing also algorithms that somehow elicit better reasoning from humans, and also transform machines into right and consistent patterns in that regard. And now, my really more recent projects are about transforming unstructured data, so text and videos and sounds, into concepts, and therefore from concepts into something that can be easily graspable from even novels, people not expert on the domain. And transforming information that is that into transparent information is not very easy for machine in particular. But we are doing our best, and I'm humbly also participating in several international projects. And this was one of the results. Last year, we published a book for Springer, where we try to leverage on knowledge graph as a quite straightforward and robust tools for representing knowledge to go ahead in the research and to support the partnership between humans and machines in a heuristic perspective. So this is now a pipeline of what I'm actually dealing. I'm dealing with the sources management to validate the information. Then we try to model how data are conceptualized by people and by machines so that to see whether they overlap or not. And then we fine-tune concepts. I mean, we're moving from concept to tools and to the final overall insight experience of the patient, for example, or the doctor in using the shield support system. Actually, for example, I'm supporting consumers in becoming more aware of risk in animal nutrition and how this is reflecting in quality of the meat, for example. Going ahead or crossing the pushing messages from the marketing from different companies and to assess what are the selling cues so that take the best can be applied on real grounding truth information, not just on the marketing information. And so these are some of the techniques that we are applying. We are helping machines to recognize concepts, to project into ontology, and to, let's say, to be accessible to novels in that regard. And I hope that I'm ready for the future to keep alive ABC core messages and the girls' spirits with us. Thank you so much.